Hi guys. I'm Overland Awful, and it is February 16th, 2020. I always have a hard time trying to get the words out of the date, because either I'm thinking too much of what I'm going to say, or I'm distracted. So it's a little bit of both today. As you can hear, we're listening to the beautiful voice of Meliane and Fatai, good friends from my YSA days, young single adult days. Now we're mid-single adults and still single. But today I'm going to overshare because a lot has happened. And a lot of gems have come our way, my way. Hope you're having a good Sunday. I have to hold my phone because I don't have those, like, stick things, whatever those things are called. Two words today, more, and hiding, and third word would be, gratitude. And so I wanted to start off with, what do you do for yourself when you want more for yourself? In life, in relationships, in friendships. And I've been on this recent rising vibe of not wanting only more for myself, but more for whoever I'm around. And so why would I want more? I feel like I've gone through this phase where I've always wanted more, in seeking out to want more for other people. I thought naively, that's not even a word, but I was naive in the thought process that to want more and to help people get more, that I was getting for myself, when really I was going backwards. And now that the light bulb has gone off in my head, and I'm trying to match my mindset with my actions, wanting more for myself has actually helped me so that I don't, like, mess around with other people and trying to inspire them to want more for themselves. Because at the end of the day, like I've said over so many videos, we can't control anyone else but ourselves. So if you're in a space where you're just, like, frustrated and you're wondering, like, oh, I'm this person and I do all these great things and yet nothing's panning out for me, I would say take a step back, breathe, and figure out, okay, what is your intention? What is your intention in wanting more for yourself and for others? And then get to the basics and just start from there, like, step by step by step by step. And I promise you, when you start to want more for yourself and do what you need to do to get that, you will be happier. I just watched a video, Tony Robbins, and he, off of, I think it's Ben Lyons, I'll tag it. You guys know when I forget, I'll tag. But he's one person. I think his name's David, that's out in the East Coast, and I always repost his stuff, because he has motivational script, and sometimes it's matched to Eric Thomas, and sometimes it's matched to Les Brown, or in this case, it was Tony Robbins. And Tony Robbins was saying that success and failures don't just happen. Like, it's the little things that you do every day. So if you're doing little things and it's not serving you, like, you're not getting up, you're not even brushing your teeth, you're not moving around, you're not going out, those little things add up to the big, huge failures. And then if you are doing the things that you need to, like, you're saying your prayers, you're being active in getting those prayers to become reality, you're eating better, you're exercising, then those things build up and all of a sudden you have major, massive success. But my takeaway from that is that those things happen when you're in a mindset and a heart, like your heart is framed around getting there by being patient with yourself. And so, in a nutshell, talking about wanting more for yourself, do the little things daily. Do the little things and just keep going. What was the second one that I said? This is why it's bad not to write things down, but I hate writing things down because I hate getting distracted by the paper or the text message. But I'll go to gratitude because I swear. Oh, no, go back. More, wanting more for yourself means, at least to me, it means stop hiding. Stop hiding who you really are. Stop hiding how you really feel because you don't want to face facts and face fears. Facts like, okay, maybe I'm not the best cook because I don't go and buy the best foods, which leads to bad health. That's an example of hiding the fact that I feel crappy because I'm not eating right. And so because I'm not eating right, I'm going to continue to not eat right. And then the cycle is don't eat right, feel crappy. And then crappy feels like looking crappy. Looking crappy feels like being a jerk to other people who might be looking better because you're in this never-ending cycle of hiding. Another thing of hiding behind relationships that are not working, having the fear of being alone. If you're not getting the love that you deserve and more, that is hiding that you're unhappy. And when you're unhappy in a relationship, and I've never in my life have been in a steady relationship. I've had spurts of years where I talk to somebody or I date somebody for a little bit, and a little bit means like maybe a month if it gets to that. But all those experiences, I could hide behind it and like be the biggest like depressing person and blame them for who I am today, or I can look back at that experience, those heartbreaks, and fix it now. Look at the patterns that led me to those bad relationships or those flaky relationships and fix them now. Don't go for or be attractive to those people. Two, have my own life. I'm so busy with my own life and goals that being in a relationship isn't obsessively the main focus every day. And this is someone who's like recovering from being obsessively wanting to be married, wanting to date. I'm recovering every day because, like my sister Caroline said, Rome wasn't built in a day. And so these bad habits and getting into bad relationships didn't get built up in a day. So it's not going to go away in a day. But it will start to go away when I stop hiding. When you stop hiding behind whatever you're doing with your trauma or your heartaches, and which causes you to be in bad habits. Stop hiding. So I'm going to get off that soapbox because I could go days on not hiding. But I will say this. If you continue to hide, you're like there's this guy with a hammer just chipping away at your heart. Chipping, chipping, chipping. And all of a sudden, one day your heart is so hard that you can't even let love in. Real love in. And real love to me looks like somebody that protects you, provides peace for you, and is undeniably front and professes. And those are like similar or spot on points that Steve Harvey like talks about. Stop hiding. And then the last thought that I want to leave this on is that as you become more and you stop hiding, gratitude will be your lifeline. Gratitude will be something you will want to feed your soul every day, all day. I just told my sisters last night, like, I started my gratitude journals again. It's been a couple of days, but this week that's going to be a major like go-to. And that was inspired by, what's his name? He's the tattoo artist, at Frost City. Local Fred Frost. Everybody knows Fred Frost, his place. So anyways, have gratitude. Once you have gratitude, things will follow. So let's stop hiding. Do more for ourselves, so we can give more of ourselves and lead in gratitude. Love you guys. Love you guys. Hope you're having a good Sunday. We're gonna get stronger on this because I'm just tired. Tired of like having this passion of having these videos impact, and I'm talking to myself and that's fine. So it's just going to be ongoing. Here we are. Ta-da. I love you guys. Have a happy Sunday. We will talk to you soon.